What is a stored procedure in SQL Server? Hi, I'm M. Asif Hussain from KnowHow Academy. What are you going to learn from this video? You are going to see what is a stored procedure, some examples of stored procedure, a type of stored procedure with parameters. You are going to see how to alter a stored procedure. You are even going to see how to view the stored procedure and how to drop a stored procedure. At the end of this video, you will have a very quick and very intensive idea on how to create a stored procedure, how to use it, and when to use it. So let's walk into it. Let me give you a simple example. You all go to a supermarket. We all go to a store. Am I right? So when we go to a store, we purchase multiple products. Okay. Our intention of going to store might be to purchase only one product. But when we go inside, we see a lot of products there. Dairy products, biscuits, chips, multiple things, right? So now when we go inside, we try to purchase multiple products. Now when we want to come out, we have to do the billing and we will come out. Now when this particular supermarket people or the technical staff of it, if they want to see what all the products that have been purchased multiple times or which products are have been purchased, you know, in a huge quantity and so on, so they don't need to. For example, let me take biscuits. Okay, if we talk about a biscuit, then let us take Dark Fantasy. Okay, so Dark Fantasy biscuit, they would like to see what is the price of it, how many people have purchased it, and when what quantity. So when they want to see all these things, if they want to write a query, they need to write a lengthy query. So they don't need to write a lengthy query if they use this stored procedure. So what happens, just you write the code and what all the result you are expecting, you will get it n number of times. Okay, so a stored procedure, it is nothing but it is also a group of SQL statement only. But when you want to write the same query multiple times, in order to avoid that, you can write a specific query with a stored procedure, and you can use only that stored procedure name to call it n number of times, multiple times. So this is a very interesting thing about a stored procedure. So if I want to give it to you a very simple example, so here on the screen, let me retrieve a table called KnowHow employees, select star from KnowHow employees. Now if I execute it, we can see that we have employee ID, we have employee first name, we have employee last name, we have employee gender, and we have employee salary. So these are the five columns that we have in our particular data set. Now if you see it here, we have employee gender column, and we know that there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so there are 5 males and 2 females. Okay, so now I want to create a stored procedure in order to see the name and gender. For example, if I want to see employee first name and employee gender information from my KnowHow employees table, now what I will do, I can write this select employee first name comma, I can write employee last name comma, I will also write the gender column. So I want to see these 3 columns, that's why I have written these 3 column names. From which table I want to extract all these informations, fetch it from KnowHow employees. So if I execute it, yes, I am getting my employee first name, I am getting my employee last name, I am getting my employee gender. But every time if you want to see this employee first name, last name and employee gender, you have to write this complete SQL select statement. Am I right? Select employee first name comma, employee last name comma, employee gender from KnowHow employees table. So now the point is that to avoid this big SQL select statement to write, we can just create a stored procedure without any parameters. Now I will show it to you how to create a procedure. It is very simple. Okay, now what I am doing, I am creating a procedure with a procedure name. So let me start with SP. Do not give underscore because that is system given name, SP underscore the name. So don't go with it. You know, without giving underscore, we can continue it. Okay, so SP, let me call it as KNWEMP. Okay, KnowHow employees, for example, if I have created it as begin, we need to write this select statement in between this begin and end. Okay, so a very simple syntax of a stored procedure. We need to create a procedure with a procedure name as as you have to begin the SQL select statement, then you need to write the select statement here. And as you have begun it, you need to end it. In between this begin and end, we need to write the select statement. So now what I'm doing, I'm just executing it. We can see that the commands completed successfully. Now I don't need to write the complete select statement again in order to see my three column names, as simple as such. So what I'm going to do here, I'm just using this procedure name, and if I execute it, I will get three columns that I want. So now you use this select, stored procedure name n number of times. Whenever you want to execute, you execute it, you will get these three column names. No need to write the complete select statement. So I did not apply any parameters here. Okay. So where is my stored procedure stored? Okay. So if I come to my Object Explorer, if I refresh my complete database, so we can see that we have this know-how under know-how. Okay. So we have programmability. Under programmability, we have stored procedure. We can see that my stored procedure with the name KNWEMP is created. Okay. So this is where my stored procedure is stored. But if we talk about the difference between a stored procedure and a view is not stored anywhere. It is a virtual table. But a stored procedure, it is saved, and this stored procedure name, you can use it to call n number of times over and over again. Okay. So but a view, once it is a virtual table, it is just to view once. If you close the query, your view is gone. Okay. But stored procedure is not like that. So that is the difference between stored procedure and a view. Now let me show you how can we create the stored procedure with the parameters. Now what is a parameter? That I'll guide it to you here. Now what I'm doing, I am creating a stored procedure with the procedure name such as SP training, stored procedure training. This is the name I have given it. Now you can choose any name of your choice. Now what I'm doing, as begin. So when we are using a stored procedure, please make sure that if you want to use a parameters, you need to use a parameter before you write the as. Okay, after you give the stored procedure name, you need to specify the parameter. Now what is mean by parameter? If I execute you this table KnowHow employees, so we have five columns. Now for example, if you want to see the employee ID, who are belonging to employee ID 1 and what is their gender. Okay, so if you want to see employee ID 1, how much is their salary. Okay, so for example, if you want to see males and how much is their salary. So rather than writing the select statement with the where clause, you can create a stored procedure with the parameter and just give the required information, what all you want, you will get the result. I'll show it to you here. Creating procedure with a procedure name. Now you need to write this @ symbol here, which is a local variable. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to mention the parameter here, employee ID. That is a parameter I'm giving it. Employee ID is a number, that is why I'm taking it as integer data type, comma. Then I am taking employee gender. Let me take employee gender. Employee gender. So it is a character I am giving as varchar with a size 50. Okay. So now what I am doing, as begin. Now I am writing the select statement. What I am writing? Select employee first name, comma, employee last name, comma. I even want to see my employee gender here. From which table? From KnowHow employees table. Where? Now this is the important part. Where? Here I want to use the parameter. So how should I use the parameter? Where? Let me write my column name. I want to see what? Employee ID. Employee ID equal to. So whatever the employee ID you would like to call, that you need to specify it. That's where you have to use it here. And what is the another thing that you would like to look into it? Which is employee gender. So if you want to call whichever employee gender, you need to specify it here. Employee gender. So now what I am doing, I am calling it over here. So I have written this one. Now it is end. Alright. So now what I am doing, I am reusing the parameters in order to see my employee ID and employee gender, whichever I want of my choice, whatever the user wants. Okay. So I am creating this one and I am executing it. Commands completed successfully. Now how to execute this stored procedure? This is very important. As I told here, you can just use the stored procedure name, or what can you do? You can even use this one, execute. What is the stored procedure name? SP training is my stored procedure name. Okay. I am taking this stored procedure name. Now what is this employee ID? employee ID, let me take 1, comma, I want to see the gender, let me check about the males in the table. So now if I execute it, we can see that employee ID 1 belongs to Raj, Darji and Karnav, who are males. Okay, so these are the two. So if I want to cross check it with you, let me execute this one. So see that employee ID 1 belongs to Raj and Karnav, who are males. Okay, so if you just want to change whichever the required information you would like to search, for example, if you want to see employee ID 3, if they are males, okay, if I execute it, there are 3 people, Ajay, Asif and Gaurav, who are males and their employee ID belongs to 3. So this is how you can use a parameter and you can create a stored procedure. So now what's happening, whenever you want, you just use this stored procedure name and fetch the details without writing this complete select statement. It will call it to you over and over again. Alright, so this is how you can create a stored procedure with the parameters. Now see, for example, I have created this stored procedure already, am I right? Now I want to do some modifications to it. For example, I would like to order it by the name with the employee first name. All right, so I want to do some small change to it here, to the existing stored procedure that I have created. So if I try to execute it, you will get an error that it is already there in the database. Okay, so what you have to do, you have to do the changes. So when you want to do a change to the stored procedure, you should go with the alter command. Okay, so what I'm doing here, I'm just using alter here, alter procedure with the procedure name. Now I want to order it by the first with the employee's first name. So commands completed successfully. If I execute it, we can see that all with the first name we got aligned in order. All right, so this is how you can alter a procedure using an alter command. All right, so if you want to view the stored procedure, for example, I have executed it and I have closed my SQL query and all. Now I have taken up a new page and I would like to see, or I would like to view my stored procedure that I have created. So how should you do that? So for that, we need to use sp underscore help text, and I would like to see the stored procedure sp training. Okay, I'll copy it and I will execute it. So when I execute it, you can see that all the text of what exactly my view I have created, everything you will see it here in a step by step. Okay, this is how you can view a stored procedure using sp underscore help text. All right, if you would like to drop a stored procedure, to drop a table, the syntax is very simple, drop table table name. To drop a procedure, it is also very simple, drop procedure procedure name. How can you drop it? I am writing drop procedure. If you do not want to write a procedure, you can even write PROC. It is up to you, PROC. Now I will take the procedure name, this one. I would like to drop this procedure, stored procedure without parameter that I have created. So if I executed, commands completed successfully. Now I will come to my object explorer. I will refresh it and I will show it to you. Under programmability, we don't have this stored procedure. We have only SP training and KnowHow employees, but we don't have this KNWEMP. KNWEMP is not there. So this is how you can drop a stored procedure. So in this video, we have seen how to create a stored procedure without parameter. We have also seen how to create a procedure with parameter. We have seen what is a stored procedure. We also have seen what is this altering the procedure, how to view the procedure, and how to drop the stored procedure in our SQL server. My dear friends and viewers, so this stored procedure in real time will be very much helpful for you if you want to see some client specific information. For example, if I take a product data, for example, if you are working on a business or a client whose business is purely dependent upon a product. So for example, if a product of a HP accessories, okay, so if you would like to see the accessory information every time, so don't need to write a select statement. You can just use this stored procedure with the accessory name and you can reuse it over and over again, which will, you know, time taking process. And the benefits of stored procedure is you can reduce the time, you can increase the speed of a programmability, takes lesser size and space and so on. So using a stored procedure will be very much helpful if you want to recall any information n number of times from a table. So thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as your source for IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate the tech world. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to reach out. It's been a pleasure sharing this information with you. Stay curious and keep learning.